everyone, my name is Evie Lupine. Welcome back to my channel, and today I have another video for you all. Today we're going to be discussing some of the key things I look for when I'm evaluating a potential dominant. Now, this is by no means an exhaustive list. This is just some of the things that I have really learned to focus on when somebody approaches me and they're interested in playing together or possibly pursuing power exchange. And I think it's really important to sit with yourself and figure out exactly what traits and what features you're looking for in a potential dominant, besides this vague thing called dominant energy, because that can come in so many different forms. And I think the more that you can specify what you're looking for, the easier it will be to evaluate potential prospects to see, is this somebody who fits with what I need in BDSM? Is this somebody that I can grow in a relationship with? Are we going to be compatible? And especially if you're evaluating somebody online, that process can be very difficult, but being able to have that specificity of knowing what you want, knowing what you need, is such a helpful tool to have. And so hopefully while you're watching this video, where I am going over some of my own ideas that kind of sparks some ideas in you to figure out what it is that you're looking for, and hopefully that'll be something that helps you on your journey. So let's go ahead and get into it. Let's start with the number one thing that I look for in a potential dominant, and really anybody I interact with in the BDSM world, or everywhere actually, and that is honesty. Honesty is absolutely key. It is fundamental to having a BDSM relationship. Not to mention, of course, having a vanilla relationship for that matter. It really doesn't matter what the groundwork for the relationship is. I do truly believe that honesty has to be the first thing. If somebody lies a lot, when they're going to be late, if they are deceitful, if they are hiding things from you, if you can't trust what they say, if they double speak, if they try to convince you that events that happened didn't happen, or things that didn't happen actually happened. Basically, if they are somebody where you don't really know if they're ever giving you the full story, they're probably not going to be somebody who will make a good, serious BDSM partner. And for me, it's just really key for my personality, because I need to know that that person is reliable in what they say, that they're going to be truthful with me, and that is what allows me to develop trust as a submissive. If somebody cannot be completely honest with me, if they conceal things, if they lie by omission, that completely destroys my ability to submit, because I no longer understand what their motivations are, or if they really care about me, or if they're motivated to be part of this relationship. And it's so difficult, I think, for many people to develop submission without that trust. And that trust is developed with honesty. So if somebody can't be honest, they're probably not going to be a very good dominant for most people, and they are not really somebody that I would encourage you to have a relationship with. Just honest people don't generally make big personality changes overnight, and I would not recommend going into a relationship with somebody that you think isn't being completely honest with you, because you assume that you can change them or you can get them to open up, because that is a very, very rare thing to happen. Number two, the second trait that I look for is self-knowledge. This is a big one for me in particular, because my personality as a submissive and kind of how I want to be able to interact with a dominant is, I don't want to have to be the coach. I don't want to have to be the person who has to baby step somebody through their own desires and their own needs and what they want out of a potential BDSM relationship. I know there are many people who are very well suited to that role. I know many people who are submissive and get great joy out of being able to bring in their new partners to the scene, of being able to help a new dominant find their footing. I know that I am not that person. I just know that I can't be that. And I love giving people advice online. I love being and help other people with their relationships. But for me, and kind of the journey that I've been on, because I am relatively new myself in terms of people who have been in the scene for 20 or 30 years, I prefer to have a partner who kind of already really knows what they're looking for. And so by self-knowledge, I mean, they know what they want and what they don't want generally. They know what their limits are. They know what their boundaries are. They know what kind of BDSM relationship they're looking for. They know if they're looking for a top or a bottom. They know if they're looking for a long-term relationship, if they're looking for a high level or a low level of power exchange, if they're comfortable with polyamory or if they need monogamy. I really value somebody who has a lot of introspection and is able to look back on themselves and see what they need from a relationship, and also to be able to evaluate their strengths and weaknesses. I love it when a dominant can tell me when they've made a mistake. I love it when they can tell me this is a time when I messed up, or here's a flaw that I had, or here's something that I'm actively working on. And I also love it when people know what their strengths are and they're able to play those in a BDSM relationship. Somebody who knows that they are very creative. Somebody who knows that they are very skilled with floggers. Somebody who knows that they are very good at being able to cook a good meal or entertain or whatever it happens to be. But somebody who just has a strong internal sense of themselves that they can then communicate to the world. I really struggle to interact on an intimate basis with somebody who hasn't really found themselves yet or doesn't really know what they want yet. And again, I want to emphasize, this is definitely a personal thing for me. This is not saying that these people make bad dominants in general. They are just not the right type of dominant for me. All right, number three is consistency. Consistency, like honesty, I think is so, so key in a relationship. And for me, this is important because the type of DS I am looking for is one that is structured, one that has rules, one that has guidelines, one that has expectations for me. And I need to know that that structure is going to stay together, not because I am the one holding the structure up, but because my partner and I are working together to hold that structure up. And for me, what I have to do is I have to listen to the structure, I have to remember the rules, I have to follow protocol. And then on the other side, my partner, my dominant, my potential dominant, has to be able to be consistent with enforcing those rules, remembering those rules, being consistent on checkups that they're supposed to do, reminders that they're supposed to give me, even just little things like being able to remember that, oh, this week we've scheduled to do this particular activity, or every week we are supposed to do this one thing, and being able to be consistent with that, because structured BDSM falls apart without consistency. And so if you're trying to do something where you have a weekly schedule or you have a weekly task you're supposed to do and you're constantly keeping it up, but then your partner isn't reminding you about it, if they're not checking in on it, if they've kind of fallen off the wagon, that is something that just absolutely makes me struggle as a submissive. And so I really need my partner to be able to be consistent with enforcement, be consistent with checking up, and just generally being a consistent person in general. If somebody says that, yeah, great, I can meet you next Sunday, they don't forget about it. Or maybe we have a date night scheduled every Friday and we have that and it's consistent and they remember about it. Whatever it happens to be, just knowing that they are going to be able to follow along with the structure that they set. And that is something that really helps, I think, the relationship run smoothly and helps facilitate a path by which the BDSM can grow. Because if you're struggling with being consistent with the very basic elements, you don't really have a strong foundation to build complexity on. Because if you can't be consistent with, like, remembering what the safe word is, or if you can't be consistent with checking in before a scene or whatever it is, and it can even be little things like, oh, I'm supposed to be consistent with reminding my submissive to drink, you know, 60 ounces of water a day or whatever, and they don't do that, you know, you're not really going to be able to get to higher and higher levels of power exchange if you can't be consistent with the groundwork. So that's why that one's important to me. Number four is empathy and emotionality. I'm not really sure how to describe this one, but I myself am a very emotive person. I primarily interact with the world through my sense of feelings and my emotions. That's how I relate to other people. This is not to say I throw logic by the wayside. I think I'm relatively balanced between logic and emotion, but I generally do let emotion lead the way. And so in turn, I know that I need a partner who can be emotional back with me, who, like the self-knowledge portion, has knowledge of their own emotions, has knowledge of their feelings, who knows how to communicate those things. And I know from past experience, I don't deal well with people who purely run on logic. That is just not something that works for me, because I need somebody who can truly understand my feelings and sympathize with my feelings, rather than trying to explain them away with logic, rather than trying to replace feelings with logic, because I think they work best together rather than one instead of the other, if that makes sense. So I need somebody who, as a dominant, can be honest about their feelings and emotions, who knows when they're angry or when they are sad or when they're upset with something, who understands kind of their own nuances between what's the difference between when I'm frustrated and I'm hungry and I'm all these other things. And I really struggle being submissive when I'm with a partner who has inconsistencies in their emotions or is unable to identify their emotions, because if my partner is like consistently feeling really poorly all the time and we don't know what's causing it, we don't know what it is, and we can't identify the emotions, it makes it really difficult to know what to do in that situation, and it just absolutely does not work with my brain. And I think for me, a big part of developing a DS relationship is being able to connect on a deep emotional level. And if somebody doesn't value their emotionality, if they don't have a deep sense of empathy, and I don't feel like my feelings are being received about activities, and those feelings aren't being used to kind of inform how the DS relationship goes, I feel really badly as a submissive, because I don't feel like I'm getting that emotional intimacy. If I don't know when my partner is upset with me or frustrated or angry or sad or happy or feeling loved or loving me or whatever it is, I can't do that. And I think being able to experience emotions and logic together in balance is a really, really great way of having scenes. And I think being able to play with these deeper emotions, being able to play with these feelings, is something that can take your average everyday flogging or spanking scene based to one that is not only driven by sensation, but is also layered kind of with extra seasoning, extra flavor on top by all of the different emotional experiences you're having at the same time. Last one for this video, this is number 5, and it would be drive/motivation. I am somebody who is a very motivated person. I'm always striving for growth. I'm always trying to learn more. I'm always trying to be better. I am always seeking out new knowledge. And I really need a partner that can do that with me, because the reason why, at least in my experience, a lot of relationships die is stagnation. And if I am with somebody who is, I don't want to say they're okay with stagnation, but they're not like a self-starter with seeking knowledge, with growth, with asking questions, with being curious about the world, that's generally not a good sign to me. I need somebody who wants to be on a journey together, going down a pathway of discovery, of wanting to know more, and it's just something that I find is really important to all of my relationships. As well, again, this kind of goes back to what I talked about earlier with needing somebody who has self-knowledge. And I think a lot of that comes together in that like self-knowledge portion of this video. It all kind of connects there. But I think that having somebody who, I don't want to feel like I'm dragging somebody into BDSM, I guess. I really don't enjoy that feeling of not knowing of if they want to do this or if they're doing it because I want it and I asked for it or whatever it happens to be. I really don't like that feeling. I prefer to have confidence in my partner knowing that they are doing this because they want to. They are doing this because they have their own motivations to do so, and it's not purely just about kind of going along with whatever I've said that I wanted to do. And in addition, I think it's also something that I find just to be a kind of dominant trait to go out there and be a go-getter and a self-starter and wanting to constantly better yourself and be a better leader, because I think that is something that makes a better leader and something that helps one cultivate dominant energy, is having that drive of knowing that you are a dominant, being confident in that, and then pursuing that, about truly wanting to have mastery over the art of dominance, if that makes sense. I want somebody who wants to reach a level of excellence. And as well, this doesn't necessarily have to be with BDSM, even though I'm thinking about it, but being driven and motivated in your career, in your life, in your hobbies, in your general pursuits. I want somebody who wants things. Now, I just want to remind everybody as I am wrapping up this video, these are based on my own personal needs. This is not an exhaustive list. This is not meant to be a guide or a prescription or anything for anyone. I am hoping that with this video, you will be able to get some ideas for what you want to look for in a dominant, what you want to evaluate, what you should be looking for. Not necessarily taking my list as gospel, but just finding some inspiration in some of the things I have said here. You've probably also noticed that I didn't mention anything about looks or gender identity or sexuality or preference for monogamy or polyamory or things like that. And to be honest, those are almost secondary considerations for me, with the exception of being okay being in an open relationship, because I am already in one. So that's kind of like a all over number one. Of course, obviously you're going to need to be at least this in order for me to even consider anything else. And I just find for myself that those sort of traits don't really come into play as much as the personality aspects do. And I think it's helpful to know that, because it's really easy to get suckered in by somebody who maybe doesn't have that great of a personality, because you find them really attractive, because they have a lot of money, because they have reputation or status, or they're a lot older than you are, whatever it is. So it's just kind of important to remember, what are your long-term priorities and how do these things affect your long-term priorities? Anyways, hopefully you guys found this video interesting and helpful. If you did, if you have any comments or questions, please feel free to put that down in the comment section below. Links to my social media, everything else is in the description box. If you haven't already and like this video, please do subscribe. I make videos twice a week. And finally, if you want to support this channel, you can do so down below by going over to Patreon and checking out all of my different perks and rewards. I have tons of cool things going over on Patreon, exclusive videos and photo shoots, a Discord chat, Fet Life, all of that cool stuff. If you want to check it out, link is down below. And until I see you guys next time, hope you have a great rest of your day and a great rest of your week. Bye-bye.